All right, we're going to talk fishing into bunker schools for monster striped bass. So the Atlantic menhaden is one of the main bait fish for striped bass. When there's a ton of Atlantic menhaden around, you tend to get into some very big fish. And I was super fortunate this summer to actually get into these crazy schools of Atlantic menhaden, both during the day and at night, to catch some really awesome fish. And I caught and got onto some amazing bites along with it. So I'm gonna take you guys kind of through what I will do when there are a ton of Atlantic menhaden around, which go by many names: bunker, pogies, Atlantic menhaden, whatever. So I call them bunker. I think that it depends on where you are on the East Coast, but I think a lot of guys that are where I'm at in the North Shore kind of call them bunker. But anyway, so I digress with that. But the thing that makes Atlantic menhaden so important is they make up so much of the striped bass's diet that when they are around, the striped bass kind of get more attracted to where they are, and it can set up to make some epic fishing and keep some really large bass around. So what happened was there was a lot of Atlantic menhaden this spring that were dumping out of the harbors and kind of rolling down across the coast, and that was attracting a lot of those really big bass. So when I'm targeting bass that are feeding on Atlantic menhaden, because they are such a big bait fish, I like to throw large profile baits. Three of my main favorite lures that I'm throwing are going to be during, I guess I'll go daytime first and then we'll talk nighttime, but the three main lures that I like to throw when there are Atlantic menhaden around during the day is a Danny plug, a very large spook, 9-inch spook, or a pencil popper. And I like smaller pencils, like 6-inch pencil poppers, because I feel like it actually gives off a pretty realistic profile match to a large Atlantic menhaden. And I can get into, go more in depth with each thing, but they all work fantastic. I would honestly throw a Danny plug over any of them when they are close enough to throw a Danny plug at them, because what happens is the bass are looking for easy meals, and if you throw something that is slow across the school, you're going to end up getting more time for those bass to see the plug and actually go after it. So I've always found that working things super slow around the bunker schools are going to be by far your best bet on hooking a big, big fish. So I really like to throw spooks as well. Spooks are probably my main lure I do throw. I think that the casting range is kind of in between a Danny plug and a pencil popper, and so what I can do is I can actually cast it out pretty far. It has a very realistic action to an injured bunker. Atlantic menhaden has just a very realistic action, and so when I'm working those, I tend to get the best reaction from the striped bass. And the other thing that you're gonna really, that's really important is, okay, how do I find those schools? A few things that you can kind of do to look for those schools is, number one, wind blowing onshore will tend to push the schools in close. But the other thing is the striped bass themselves will push those bunker into coves along sea walls or places that they can kind of trap and corral the bait. And when that happens is they tend to force the bait together into schools and then kind of go blowing through them and feed on them. So when you're looking for them, you actually kind of target those schools of bait like you would in the fall for the baby Atlantic menhaden, or as we call them, peanut bunker. So what you do is when I'm driving around, I'm looking for these darker patches on the surface of the water, as well as more like dimply water on the surface, and I'll know, okay, that's actually a bunker school. You can't see them like you would in the fall where there would be a lot of seagulls flying around, because the Atlantic menhaden are pretty damn big, and the seagulls won't really be able to grab them. So what you'll see most of the time is maybe a cormorant or two in there, but there's not gonna be a lot of bird action. So you really have to rely on, okay, can I actually see the school of bait in the water with my binoculars? And that's like the most important thing. So looking for those darker schools where they're really pushed together, that's gonna help you out in a huge, huge way. So I'm looking, I'm driving around, I know that there's bunker around. The other thing I always look for, which is kind of the cheat, is if there are Atlantic menhaden like trolling boats which suck up the Atlantic menhaden. You can, if you see those boats, there's probably menhaden around, and if there are like singular schools of menhaden, there's going to be multiple in that area, and that's always a great way to kind of narrow down where they're going to be. But definitely looking for any sort of sign that there are Atlantic menhaden in the area is going to help you, because if you can find one school, there's going to be a ton in a few mile stretch. The other thing that I really like to do is I like to, when fishing at night, so let's switch into like fishing at night here. If you know that there's a lot of Atlantic menhaden in the area, especially in boulder fields, the bass will end up stopping off and go off of those schools and go hunt in boulder fields and I guess along the sand beaches and good rips and things. So fishing at night can be a very good option. And again, I like to throw large profile things like big deep diving metalips, big soft plastics work really well, live eels, anything along those lines that's like I'm going to target a really big bass, that tends to help in a huge way. I've always found that if you have spots that you know will hold big fish when they're there, around big moon phases, the newer the full moons, they tend to really help produce those bass. And I've had tremendous success around moon phases when there are Atlantic menhaden in the area. And then, you know, obviously if you're fishing really big fish, you want to make sure you have the right gear for it. Definitely fish with gear that's built for hooking to big fish and fighting them out of rocks and stuff. Because I had a few scenarios where there's lobster pots and I really had to horse these fish out of the rocks and around the lobster pots. So I was just like trying to be very careful when it came to that. And I think that basically covers like what I like to do when chasing down these schools for Atlantic menhaden and catching really big bass out of them. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.